But didn't the Pharisees and the Herodians find themselves in an awkward position when Jesus said, "Why are you trying to trap me?" All right, fine. Who's got one of those coins? Oh, yeah, I do. They're supposed to have one of those coins? It's pagan. It's unclean. It's blasphemy. They're not supposed to have one of those coins. But man, he says, anybody got a coin? And they reach in their pockets and they bring them out. And he says, whose inscription is on there? And they say, Caesar's. And whose inscription is on there? Caesar's. And they had to feel like that young man in sixth grade, didn't they? Because they're caught. They're hypocrites. But the August Savior, Jesus, masterfully continues on. Render to Caesar what is Caesar's, and to God what is God's. In 1 Peter chapter 2, the Apostle Peter, as he is inspired by God's Spirit, writes, submit yourselves for the Lord's sake to every authority instituted among men, whether to the king as the supreme authority or to governors who are sent by him to punish those who do wrong and commend those who do right. For it is God's will that by doing good you should silence the ignorant talk of foolish men. And then he says, live as free men. Do not use your freedom as a cover-up for evil. Live as servants of God. Don't get caught up in the foolishness, in the hypocrisy, in the utter waste of time of this world and its schemes. Live free and serve God.